Okay, this is math for Wednesday, January 6th, and we will be doing math work text, page 163, 164, and math reviews, page 161, 162. All right, and we will be learning about mixed numbers today. Now, a mixed number is just a whole number and a fraction mixed together, okay? A whole number means you have the whole thing, okay? It doesn't matter if it's been divided up. Like when you order a pizza from Domino's and they bring it to you in a box, you open up the box and it is one whole pizza. But that pizza has been cut into slices already, so it's easy to serve up. Okay, so you still have one whole pizza, but it's been divided into pizzas. Let's say it was divided into eight pieces and you have all eight pieces there. So 8/8 is the fraction, but you still have one whole pizza. Let's say you're having a party and you needed to get three pizzas. All right, so you open up the box and there are three whole pizzas in the box, and all of them are cut into eight pieces each. So each 8/8 and 8/8 and 8/8, three whole pizzas. But then people start taking pizza. So now maybe there's one whole pizza in one box because nobody's even eaten any of that. But the other two boxes, maybe it was pepperoni and cheese, and people have eaten some of that. So now maybe one box has 6/8 and the other box has 4/8 because people are starting to eat that pizza. All right, so you have one whole pizza, and then you have 6/8 in one box and 4/8 in the other box, okay? But what we're going to do is we're going to take whole numbers, that would be you have the whole thing, and fractions, and make mixed numbers. That's what they're called. So if you look at the top, the very first thing you see is pizza. And it says a mixed number is the sum of a whole number and a fraction. When comparing mixed numbers, first compare the whole numbers, right? So you look at the one pizza and you see two pizzas, okay? Two whole pizzas. And then you look at that third pizza and it's gone. Most of it's gone. There's just one out of four. So that is 2 1/4. See underneath that pizza where it says 2 1/4? That's your mixed number. Two is the whole number. Talking about the two whole pizzas. And 1/4 is the fraction of the pizza that's left because there's one out of four pieces left. So that's 1/4. 2 1/4. You look at the other side. On the other side, there's just one whole pizza. And then there are 3/4. Now, first you're going to compare. When you're comparing, you're going to compare the whole numbers. It doesn't even matter about the fractions. If the whole numbers are different, two whole pizzas is more than one whole pizza. Right? So therefore, 2 1/4 is greater than 1 1/4. 1 3/4, excuse me. 1 3/4. Because there's two whole pizzas compared to just one whole pizza. So that one already is bigger. Now look at the second pizza. On the second pizza, you have 1 1/4. And then you have 1 3/4. This time, since the two whole numbers are the same, there's a one whole pizza here and there's one whole pizza there. They're the same. Now you have to look at fraction. So on the first pizza, there's just 1/4 in the pan that has some pizza missing. And then the second one, there's 3/4. So which one is bigger, 1/4 or 3/4? 3/4. So 1 1/4 is less than 1 3/4. All right. Now, we're going to look at number one. Number one, they show you two rectangles. But the first rectangle is completely there. Some people get caught up in counting all the pieces they've been divided up to. But you're not supposed to do that until you get to the number where you're making the fraction, okay? So if you look at the purple rectangle, there's three pieces to it, but that doesn't matter. The whole thing is colored in, right? So you have one rectangle that is complete, right? Okay, so that would be your whole number, one. All right, now you look at the other rectangle, some of it's missing. So we're going to make a fraction out of that one. How many pieces were there? There were three. So the denominator is going to be three. And how many pieces were colored purple? Two. So this mixed number is 1 2/3. And that's what you need to write in those orange boxes beside it. 1 2/3. You have one whole purple box. Now that purple box, a rectangle, was divided into three sections. But for the first one, all three sections are colored purple. So you have that whole rectangle. For the second rectangle, it's still divided into three sections, but you only have 2 out of 3. That's how you get 1 2/3. 1 is your whole number because you have the whole rectangle. 2/3 is the fraction for that other rectangle. Right? And that's how you would do it. You would put the whole number in that first orange box, and then the 2/3 would be in the two boxes beside it where they have the fraction. All right, we're going to go to the next one. The next one is a yellow circles. Okay? So first we have a yellow circle. Now both yellow circles are divided into four sections. They're divided into fours. But the first circle, you have the whole circle. All four sections of that circle are colored. So how many whole circles do you have? 1. You have 1 complete circle. Now look at that second circle. It also is divided into four sections, so that's going to be your denominator, 4. How many sections are colored yellow? 3. So that's your numerator. So how many circles do you have? You have 1 3/4. One whole circle. Does not matter that it's divided. Get over that part. Some people keep getting obsessed with the fact that it's cut into four pieces. It doesn't matter. All four pieces are there. So you have one whole circle. And then for the other circle, you have 3/4 because you have 3 out of the 4 pieces. Okay? Let's move on to the next one. Alright, the next one is another rectangle. And you see that there's actually 3 of them there. 3 rectangles. Only one of them is not complete though. The first rectangle is divided into 8 pieces. The second rectangle is divided into 8 pieces. The third rectangle is divided into 8 pieces. That's the one where there's some missing. So how many complete rectangles do you see? You should have said 2. So that is your whole number. Your whole number on this one is 2. Because you have 2 complete rectangles where all the pieces in it are colored. The first one has 8 pieces in it. All 8 pieces are colored orange. The second one has 8 pieces and all 8 pieces are colored orange. But that third rectangle, how many pieces are there? There's still 8 pieces. So there's your denominator. How many pieces are colored orange? 3. So what is that mixed number? 2 3/8. Notice you say the word and in between the whole number and the fraction. 2 3/8. Right? Now, we're going to look at some triangles. In the next section, for number four, you see some triangles. Now, the triangles are divided in half, okay? So, you see the first triangle, the second triangle, the third triangle, and the fourth triangle. All of them are divided into 2 pieces. But if you look at the first triangle, both pieces are colored purple. Look at your second triangle. Both pieces are colored purple. Look at the third triangle. Both pieces are colored purple. But look at that last triangle, that fourth triangle. Only one of the pieces is colored purple. So how many whole triangles did you have? You had 3. There were 3 complete triangles where both halves were colored purple. But on that last triangle, only 1 out of 2. So since there's 2 pieces, that's your denominator, and only one of those 2 pieces is colored purple. So that would be 3 1/2. 3 1/2. All right. Now we are going to compare mixed numbers. So look at number 5. Number 5, they show you 2 complete circles. Again, both of those circles are cut in half, but they're both completely there. And then they show you one right below that. It's a complete circle, but only one part of it was colored yellow. So that was the number 2 1/2. And you can look underneath those 2 circles in that half and they have written 2 1/2. Then you go to the other side right beside it, and you see 2 complete circles, and you see, again, 1/2. 2 1/2, 2 1/2, that would be equal. They're the same, exactly the same, so put an equal sign there. All right, so go to number 6. Number 6, you see a long, skinny rectangle that has 4 pieces, so that's 1 rectangle. And then you see right below it another long, skinny rectangle that has 4 pieces, so that's 2 complete rectangles. Then the one below that, it's not completely there. So your whole number is going to be 2, but the fraction for that last rectangle is 2/4. So you can see that underneath that, you can see 2 2/4. Everybody see that? Now go to the other side. On the other side, you have 1 rectangle divided into 4 pieces, so you have the whole thing, so that's 1. And the next one is not the whole thing. So your whole number is 1, and your fraction is 3/4, because that's 3 out of the 4 pieces is there for that second rectangle. So your whole numbers are 2 2/4 and 1 3/4. All you have to do is look at your whole numbers, because 1 has 2, 1 only has 1. So the one that has 2 whole ones is greater than 2 2/4 is greater than 1 3/4. All right, look at the blue ones for number 7. All right, the first one, it shows a small rectangle, 3 sections. The whole thing's colored though, so that's your whole number. And the next one underneath that, only 1 of those 3 sections is colored, so there's your fraction. So that's 1 1/3, because 1 out of 3 was colored for that next rectangle. So that first whole number is 1 1/3. So look on this other side right beside it, and you see 2 whole ones, completely colored. The first one, all 3 sections are colored. The second one, all 3 sections are colored. So there's your whole number, 2. And for the last one, again, they only have 1 out of the 3, so that's 1/3. So 1 1/3, 2 1/3. Remember what I said. If your whole numbers are different, just look at the whole numbers. Don't worry about the fraction. 1 had only 1 whole one, 1 had 2. So therefore, that's 1 1/3 is less than 2 1/3. Because 1 is less than 2. The whole number is the only thing you need to compare when your whole numbers are different. All right, now we're just going to look without a picture. All right, so look at number 8. Number 8 says 1 2/3. And then beside it, it says 1 1/3. All right, they both have a whole number of 1. So let's just look at the fraction. 2/3, 1/3. Our denominators are the same. So what's greater, 2 or 1? 2. So 1 2/3 is greater than 1 1/3. All right, the next one says 3 4/5 and 2 4/5. All right, so all we have to do is look at our whole numbers. Our whole numbers are 3 and our whole number is 2. 3 is greater than 2, so 3 4/5 would be greater than 2 4/5. All right, that last one, number 10, says 1 3/6, and the other number is 1 4/6. All right, well, the whole number for the first one is 1, the whole number for the second one is 1, so that's the same, so look at your fraction. 3/6 and 4/6. Which one's greater, 3 or 4? 4, very good. So gobble up the 4, the 1 4/6, 1 3/6 is less than 1 4/6. All right, as soon as you've done that, turn your paper over and let's look at the back. All right, the first thing we're going to do, we're going to be writing those mixed numbers again. All right, so look at that circles. All right, all the circles are divided into 4 sections, but you see all the sections for the first one colored, so that whole thing is there. Then you see all the sections for the second one are colored, so that's 2 so far. Are all the sections for that third circle colored? No, they're not. So what's our whole number going to be? 2. We have 2 complete circles colored. Now look at that third circle. How many sections are there? 4. So that's your denominator for the fraction part. And how many are colored? 3. So that mixed number is 2 3/4. 2 complete circles and 3/4 of the other one. All right, Moving on to the next one. Number two, you have some rectangles. All right. All these rectangles are divided into six pieces. If you look at the first rectangle, all six pieces are colored. You look at the second one, all six pieces are colored. You look at the third one, all six pieces are colored. So what's our whole number? Three. We have three complete rectangles. Now let's look at that fourth rectangle. Are all the pieces colored? No. What's our denominator going to be? How many pieces are there? Six. There are six pieces. Now how many of them are colored yellow? Just one. So what is our mixed number? 3 and 1/6. 3 and 1/6. Okay? So that's how you would write it. 3 as your whole number first, and then 1/6 above and below the fraction line that they have there. All right, let's look at the next one. We have some orange rectangles. All right, and they are just divided in half. So you look at the first orange rectangle. Both halves are colored. Look at the next one. Still both halves are colored. Look at the next one. Both halves are colored. Look at the next one. Both halves are colored. Look at the next one. Both halves are colored. It's not until you get to the last one where they only colored one of the two pieces. So how many did they color the whole thing? Five. Five completely colored rectangles. Do not worry about how many pieces there are. It's how many complete rectangles. All of them were divided in half, but five of them, they colored both halves. Now look at that last one. It's divided into two pieces, so what's our denominator? Two. How many of those two pieces were colored on that last one? One. So what's our mixed number? 5 1/2. 5 1/2. Right, now the last one is back to some triangles. And again, these triangles are just cut in half. So look at the first triangle. Both pieces are colored. The second triangle, both pieces are colored. The third triangle, only one of the two pieces are colored. So how many triangles did they color all of it? Two. Two triangles, they colored all of it. That last one is still divided into two pieces, so your denominator is going to be two. And how many of those pieces were colored on that last one? Just one. So that would be 2 1/2. 2 1/2. All right, now let's compare. So look at number 5. The first one shows triangles again, divided in half. One whole one and a half one. 1 1/2. The next one is 2 1/2. So let's just compare the whole number, because the whole number is not the same. You got one whole one and two whole ones. So two whole ones would be more. So 1 1/2 is less than 2 1/2. All right, look at the circles. The first set of circles, they're all divided into fours. Every circle is divided into fours. You have 1, 2, 3 complete circles where they colored all four sections blue. And then that last one, they've only colored one of the four sections blue, so that is 1/4. So you have 3 1/4, and then right beside it, you have two whole circles where they colored all of it blue, and then again, just 1/4 for that last circle, 1 out of 4. So you've got 3 1/4, 2 1/4. Again, your whole numbers are not the same, so just compare the whole numbers, 3 versus 2. 3 is greater, so 3 1/4 is greater than 2 1/4. All right, the last one, you have some itty-bitty rectangles. All of them are divided into thirds. You have all of one, you have all of a second one, and it's not until you get to that third one where they only color two of the three pieces. So that would be 2, and that last one is 2/3, because two of the three pieces are colored. Then you look at the other one, and again, they have all of the first rectangle colored, all of the second rectangle colored, so there's two again, but on that last one, they only colored 1/3. All right, so your whole number is 2, and your whole number is 2. That means you have to look at the fraction. So 2/3 versus 1/3. 2/3 is greater, so 2 2/3 is greater than 2 1/3. Now, let's compare without a picture. So look at number 8. Number 8 says 1 and 3 fifths, and right beside it says 1 and 3 fifths. So those are equal. They are exactly the same. The whole number is the same. The fraction is the same. Look at number 9. Number 9 says 2 and 3 sixths, and then it says 2 and 5 sixths. Well, 2 and 2, that's the same whole number, so look at the fraction. 3 sixths, 5 sixths. What's greater, 3 or 5? 5. So 5 sixths is greater, gobble it up. So that would be 2 and 3 sixths is less than 2 and 5 sixths. All right, your last one says 3 and 3 fourths, and then it says 2 and 3 fourths. All right, so let's just compare our whole numbers because they're different. We got a whole number of 3 and a whole number of 2. Which one's greater? 3 is greater. Gobble up the 3. 3 and 3 fourths is greater than 2 and 3 fourths. All right, now we have a story problem with a picture. It says Megan had some crackers. They look like graham crackers. She gave Erin 1 and 3 fourths crackers. So that means she gave her the whole graham cracker, plus she gave her 3 out of the 4 sections also. Then she kept 1 and 1 fourth. All right, so her friend got 1 and 3 fourths, and she had 1 and 1 fourth, and you can see a picture of it right there. So 1 and 3 fourths, since the whole number is 1 for both of them, they both had a whole one. And then her friend got 3 fourths, and she only had 1 fourth for the fraction. 3 fourths is greater, right? So 1 and 3 fourths is greater than 1 and 1 fourth. So that means she gave her friend more. All right, this next section, you are supposed to be remembering about weight. 16 ounces is a pound. Don't forget that. So since 16 ounces is a pound, and they're saying that baby's weight is either 25 ounces or 25 pounds. Well, when a baby is born, most babies are more than 5 pounds. So 25 ounces is only a little bit more than a pound. It's not even 2 pounds. So that baby, which is not even a newborn baby, it's a baby crawling around, must be 25 pounds. All right, and then a dog. That's a pretty decent sized bulldog there. So that bulldog would be probably 40 pounds. Okay, remember, 16 ounces is 1 pound. 16 and 16 is 32. Add another 16 and that's 48. So that's only 3 pounds. That would be a really small dog. All right, the next one is a bumblebee. Bumblebees are pretty light, so that would be 1 ounce, not 1 pound. And the last thing is a fawn, a little fawn. So think of a smallish dog. 10 pounds. 10 pounds. All right, let's do math reviews. I'm just going to do the first side with you. I might discuss the back with you. Yeah, we'll talk about it. I'll tell you what to do, but we're not going to do it together. You'll do it on your own. But the first part we'll do together. All right, so again, reminder in the top. Look, it says a mixed number is the sum of a whole number and a fraction. When comparing mixed numbers, first compare the whole numbers. If the whole numbers are the same, compare the fractions. And they show you that by 1 and 1 half, comparing it to 2 and 1 half. All those rectangles or squares, they are squares there, are divided in half. And you have one whole one and then a half one. And then you have two whole ones and a half one. So therefore, 1 compared to 2, 1 and 1 half is less than 2 and 1 half. Now look at the triangles. These triangles were divided into 6 sections. So we have one whole one. And then for the other one, we have 5 of the 6 sections. So that's 1 and 5 sixths. And then on the other side, we have one whole one. And then we have 2 of the 6 sections. So that's 1 and 2 sixths. Well, since the whole numbers are the same, 1 and 1, that means 5 sixths would be greater than 2 sixths. Because 5 is greater than 2. All right, now let's write the mixed number for number 1. Number 1, you have a circle. Divide it into fours. You have all 4 pieces because they're all gray. Remember, for these black and white papers, it's what's shaded. Shaded gray. So that's what you're looking at. So all of them are shaded gray. For the other one, it's still divided into 4 pieces. So that's going to be your denominator. only one of them is shaded gray. So that would be 1 1/4. So your whole number is 1. Your denominator is 4. And the numerator would be 1, because only one of those four pieces was shaded. All right, the next one is a triangle. No, I'm sorry, not a triangle. Square. It is a square, and it's been divided into 6 pieces, if you count it carefully. For the first square, they have colored all the pieces, so you have a whole square. But for the second one, they haven't colored all the pieces. So you can go ahead and put a whole number of 1, because you have one square where they colored all 6 pieces. For the other one, you still know you have 6 pieces, so that's your denominator. And how many were colored? Count the colored ones, the ones that are shaded gray. That would be 4. So that would be 1 4/6. 1 4/6. All right, let's just compare mixed numbers now. All right, first you see circles divided into 4s. All right, so you have 2 whole ones, and then you have 2 4s. So they wrote below that already, 2 2/4. Then you have 1 whole one and 3/4. Well, the whole numbers are different, so just 2 is greater than 1. So 2 2/4 is greater than 1 1/4. All right, now we have rectangles divided into thirds. You have a whole one where they colored all 3 pieces, and then right below it, they only have 1 of the 3 pieces colored. So that would be 1 1/3. The other side, they have 1 whole one colored, and then they have 2 of the 3 pieces, so that is 1 2/3. 1, the whole number is the same. They're both 1, so look at the fraction. 1/3, 2/3. 2/3 is bigger, so 1 1/3 is less than 1 2/3. All right, in number 5, you have circles. These circles are divided into fifths, 5 pieces each. You have all the first one, all the second one, and on the next one, they've colored 3 of the 5, or shaded 3 of the 5 pieces. So that would be 2 3/5, and that's what they wrote below that. On the other side, they have 2 whole ones colored, and then for the last one, they have 4 out of 5 pieces. So that's 2 4/5. So again, your whole numbers are the same. Both of them have 2 complete circles, and you have 3/5 versus 4/5. 4/5 is bigger. Gobble it up. 2 3/5 is less than 2 4/5. All right, now they want you to write the mixed numbers and compare also. All right, so I'm not going to write on my board this time. I'm just going to have you write it in. But you can see those gray boxes. You can see the first gray box is going to be for your whole number. All right, we've got rectangles. They are divided into 6 pieces. All of the first ones there, all of the second ones there, all of the third ones there. So you have a whole number of 3 for that first one. Underneath that first one, put 3 for your whole number. Now let's figure out the fraction for that last one. That last one, it still has 6 pieces, so that's your denominator. Put that on the bottom. And how many pieces are shaded gray? 1. So you should have written 3 1/6. Now go to the one right behind that. How many whole ones do you see for that? You should be saying that you see 2. The whole first bar is colored. The whole second bar is colored. It's not until you get to the third bar that they didn't color it all. So put a whole number of 2. Now let's look at the bar where they didn't color it all. Still has 6 pieces, so 6 is your denominator. Put that on the bottom for the fraction. And how many pieces are shaded gray? 4. So that would be 2 4/6. Now, when we compare, we can compare our whole numbers because they're different. 3 is greater than 2, so 3 1/6 is greater than 2 4/6. All right, and for number 7, we again have rectangles. These are divided into 10 pieces, but you have all of the first 10 pieces. You have all for the second one. It's not until you get to the third one where they only colored part of it. So you have 2 whole rectangles. So put that as your whole number. But go to the last bar in that underneath number 7. And out of the 10 pieces, how many are shaded gray? Count them carefully. It should be 6. But your denominator is what? 10. Because there are 10 little pieces. If you count all the pieces carefully, there are 10. So your mixed number should be 2 for the whole number and 6/10. Now go to the other side. This time there is only one bar where they colored all of it. So 1 is your whole number. And then again, count how many are shaded gray for the second one. And again, it's 6. 6 out of 10. So 1 and 6/10. 2 and 6/10. 1 and 6/10. All you have to do is compare them by the whole number. 2 versus 1. 2 is greater. So 2 and 6/10 is greater than 1 and 6/10. All right, turn that paper over. On the back, you have use addition to check your work. Now, you are going to subtract, and there will be renaming sometimes, but not always. And what do to check it? You add the answer, which is your difference, to what you subtracted. So in that first problem, 26 minus 14, you would be adding 14 back to whatever you got for your answer. So adding 14 back to whatever you get for your answer. Subtract it, whatever your answer is, add your answer plus 14. So whatever you're subtracting, that's what you add back to check it, just in case you forgot how to do those. For the second section, is just saying to solve, and those are all about renaming. Every single one of those has renaming. And then you have a story problem. Beth has collected 842 stamps. Eileen has collected 679 stamps. How many more stamps does Beth have than Eileen? All right, so they're asking you to compare or find the difference between how many stamps that Beth has and how many stamps Eileen has. So when you're finding the difference, you are subtracting. Remember, the answer to a subtraction problem is the difference. That's what you call it. Remember, it's minuend, subtrahend, difference. Right, so they do give you a box to put the work in. Don't forget, when you put it in that box, put the big number on top. When you subtract, you always put the big number on top. And there will be renaming with that too. And then don't forget, your label would be, it says how many more, so your label will be more, or you can say more stamps. Right. See you for language.